nerd dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 100 of the series Create a RubyGem Nerd Dice. And we have not one, not two, not three, not four, but five releases that we are going to attempt to get done in this video. So the previous video, it was a pretty long and tedious one where we went back, took the commits we've been doing since for the past, I don't know, 10 videos or so, and to master, and then kind of parsed out which ones go in version 0.4, 0.3, 0.2, and 0.1. So, and then we also updated the changelog in master. So in this video, we're going to release all these past patch versions and then release version 0.5.0, which will be a new major version. So we'll get going with that. We are going to take a look at the issue here. This is an example of one of the releases that we have. Let me take a look at the tag there. It's been a while since we've done this. Version 0.1.0, 0.1.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. We're going to double the number of tags as we do this. So the way we're going to go about this is we're going to start with 0.1.2, and we will go there. All of the changes for these will have been pushed already. So we're going to tag the latest commit in each of these branches as the release commit, and push the tags, and then we'll go from there. So check out version 0.1 stable, and we're going to do a git tag dash a, and let me make sure that, so it would be v0.1.2. sign, and then me try to figure out what it push tags. And so I should now see a tag here. Releases tags, there we go. So we now have 0.1.2. See the, so we don't have a release created off of that yet, but we do have that tag out there. Now what we do is we do gem build, pause and enter the passphrase here. All right, so we've got that, and then we're going to do gem push. Multi-factor authentication. So, got that for RubyGems. This will have long since expired by the time you watch this video, and it's incorrect anyway. Successfully registered. All right, so now we'll git move into the package directory, and we'll start with version 2. Similarly, we will git tag 0.2.1 git push tags gem build and do the passphrase. All right, and build that. Gem push. Registered 0.2.1 git checkout version 0.3 push the tags. Gem build, pause it. All right, we got that done. Zero three. Version 0.4 git tag it push the tag build this version of the gem. Four. See how things are going on. Nerd dice here. Signature validity period is showing up as correct. It indicates that it was published with multi-factor authentication. Now, let's git checkout master. To 0.5.0. And then git push the tags. Build the gem. All right, got that built. 050. And now that will show as the current version of the gem. So the other thing that we have left to do, take a look at our directory right now, git status. We are on master. We're going to move star.gem we've got that. We're going to do a bin generate checksums 0.1.2. Let's just check some of these, no pun intended. So 256 ends in 141F. That matches. I think we're good there. So we're going to now, before we, I'm trying to think of the order in which I'm going to do this. I guess before I make the changes here, we're going to git checkout the push origin. Git checkout master. And then we will do the checksums all as a separate commit here. Git add checksum, git status, git commit s, write the commit message for the checksums. All right, and in this case, I'm gonna just push this straight to master. There's the commit message. Git push. So we've got that closed, build past, look at our milestones. So certificate patch releases. Let's see here. Milestones. How do I? Oh, there we go. Milestones. Okay, so 0 point. So this milestone. Guess. Don't really need to do anything with it. I don't know how to close it. Oh, close. There's a link that says close. And we'll close 0.5. And the other things to do are in this releases section, we've got some tags now that we can draft a release off of. So create release, and then hold on, let me go back. What did we? The title is just the name of the release. Yeah, that's simple enough. So we'll go back. Create the release again. All right, I will not set that as the latest release. So I'll pause and write some release notes on this, and then we'll kind of progressively adapt them as it relates to the, actually I'll just, in this case, I'm just going to steal from the changelog. Might have to steal from the changelog using Markdown. So 0.1.2. Release. Publish it. Back to releases. Do the same thing with 0.2. That one. It's going to be, I think, verbatim the same. Create that release. publish it. And then a tag for 0.5. This one got a bold. This is going to be set as the latest release. We'll publish it. Let's see. Releases there. Let me just double check that I can from RubyGems now. Gem install nerd dice p security. There we go. Okay. What else do I need to do? I need to git checkout version 0.5 stable. We're going to git checkout version 0.4 stable with the changelog. So here we've got the legacy branch change there now. We're going to also bump the, I don't think I'm going to bump the version yet. I think with the non-master branch versions of that, I liked it better when I bumped the version right when I went to release it rather than a kind of doing it in advance. So we'll keep that the same. Git status, git commit, sign it, essentially find the same commit we had in version 4. Say instead of attributes toward, I'll say C there. Git push, git status, and then git checkout. Master on master, this is where I want to bump the minor version here. So version will now be 0.6 on master. Install rubocop rspec git status git diff. That looks like what we want. Git commit sign that commit. Oh, git add. And then git commit. The one liner says all I need to say for that. Yeah, push. Let's double check our housekeeping. It might be a bit before we return to the Nerd Dice Gem itself. I'll note in the retro that we need to. I'll need to set up a reminder to make sure that I don't let the certificate expire again. But otherwise, I think we're good here. We're all fine here now. Thank you. How are you? All right, so we'll just wait for this to. It has successfully built. We have a release, and our next video will be the retro. What will I sing? Tune in, or don't. Or tune in for the retro and not for the singing. Or I'll release the singing separately. So if you like the singing, you get the singing. If you like the whole retro with the singing, you get the whole retro with the singing. But I'll have to see what we'll do. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, spread the word. All right, I'm gonna hit stop. It's like one of those, like young teenager, like boyfriend, girlfriend phone calls. Oh, no, you hang up first. No, you hang up first. Yeah. Well, I'm hanging up. Code along on an end-to-end journey through the creation, design, and development of a Ruby on Rails application for managing tabletop role-playing games. We start from Rails new and will guide you along the journey of the entire lifecycle of the application. You'll get to see real-life, real-world problems and challenges as we try to deliver value for our users. Visit statelesscode.com to level up. Thanks for watching this Stateless Code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels. Follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.